Are you serious? Are you serious? Now Elon Musk is going to put the internet on Mars. What? Well, that's exactly what's going on. Welcome, guys. Everybody hit the thumbs up right now. Everybody hit the thumbs up. Now, Elon Musk has promised to send at least 1 million people to Mars by the year 2050. Folks, that's in the next 30 years. Can he do it? Well, in a recent interview with Time Magazine, SpaceX president and COO Gwynne Shotwell revealed the Mars plans. Shotwell said, once we take people to Mars, they're going to need a capability to communicate. In fact, she said, I think it will be even more critical to have a constellation like Starlink around Mars. Now, that's what Starlink is going to be around Earth. Pretty soon, you're going to be able to have the Elon Musk internet instead of the one you have right now. You'll have that option. She also stressed that Mars and Earth will need to be connected, a bridge. So Shotwell added that then, of course, you need to connect these two planets as well. So we make sure we have robust telecom between Mars and back on Earth. That would mean Mars and Earth would have some kind of internet bridge between them. The SpaceX COO also explained that the company isn't giving up on Earth just because it wants to aim for Mars. She said it wants to give humanity another shot in case there were to be some horrible event on Earth. Musk founded SpaceX with the aim of putting humans on other planets. He previously said his Starship rocket currently is testing will one day ferry Earthlings to Mars. He said he'll need a fleet of 1,000 ships. I've seen these. They look like a silver bullet. He has one of these. He's going to build a fleet of 1,000 of these to create a sustainable city, as orbits mean the trip is only viable once every 2 years. If you have 1,000 of these ships, then of course there's three a day going up there, bringing supplies and all kinds of equipment, food, water, and whatever else it needs to be used to sustain life on Mars. So Musk previously vowed to put 1 million people on Mars by 2050. And according to Elon Musk, SpaceX aims to build 1,000 starships at a facility in South Texas in the next 10 years. I don't know who's going to South Texas to get a job, but I would say, if you're wanting to get in on the ground floor, if a guy says he's going to build 1,000 starships in 10 years, that's 100 a year in a facility in South Texas. There's a lot of jobs getting ready to be provided in South Texas. Now, these 100 rockets per year is a pretty tall feat considering the firm hasn't built a single functioning Starship yet. But according to reports, eventually Tesla's boss added that the goal would be to launch 1,000 Starship flights to Mars every year, an average of 3 per day. Each trip would see 100 passengers make their way to the Red Planet to become citizens of Mars mega city. If you send 100 people to Mars on 1,000 different ships, starships, that is 100,000 people would actually go to Mars. Now, as these 100 people go there on the starships, they would also be bringing with them pods that connect so that these pods connect to each other. plus all kinds of, there's other starships and other ships are coming with infrastructure capabilities for electricity and for, because of the extreme cold it gets on Mars. Mars gets very cold and then gets warmer. And of course, who knows how they're going to deal with radiation. That's another whole thing. They're working on all of that. I think this is a fascinating story, really, to be quite honest with you. It's quite...
What you just said is one of the most insanely idiotic things I have ever heard. At no point in your rambling, incoherent response were you even close to anything that could be considered a rational thought. Everyone in this room is now dumber for having listened to it. I award you no points, and may God have mercy on your soul.
In the middle of the night! What? What? That's fine. God's gonna sort that out. It's not...
One day, Jesus is coming. You may be at church. You may be at work. You may be asleep. God grant that you will be ready when he makes his personal appearance. My God, what if his appearance occurs on a Sunday morning? My prophetic word to you this